Hello there, I'm DoctorDtwo, and welcome back to Astray. When we last left off, this thing fell from the sky, and we found out this place is a museum purposely meant to be spooky by stuff. And it looks like there's a weird view happening between this thing. Can't get it to work anymore. Oh well. I don't know if this fell for a reason, but I'm taking it with me, just in case I can mess with stuff again. There's nothing in here. There is nothing in here. Why do I have this, then? Am I supposed to somehow get up there? That is... There are things... There's just a vent up there. Huh. Well, I don't see anything I can do over here. Unless there's another... Whoa. There's another vent over here. That's not even a vent. That's a hole. I think I'm supposed to get up there somehow. Can I take this somehow? Can I smash it with the... Great. Come on. Take it. Nope. Okay. Well. I have seen nothing that tells me I can go anywhere. Not in this place, at least. So we rush the steam, I guess. Oh, wait, wait. That's right. I can use it to block the steam. Duh. Come here. You're coming with me. You have holes in you, but at the same time, getting hit by half the steam is gonna be better than getting hit by all the steam. Alright, push it against the wall to get a better angle. There we go. Okay. I have a shield. I highly doubt this is actually going to work. Yeah! That worked exactly as expected. Okay, oh, but I'm before this thing now. So, I'm supposed to stay here and progress here somehow. And plop. Hey, it didn't fall this time. Plop. If I shine a little, nope. You gonna fall? Are you not joining me this time, sir? I gotta read this first. Red, not red. Okay. Clang clang. There's supposed to be a clang. What else going on? Oh well. Maybe I'm not supposed to be down here yet. The steam's killing me, this place is killing me. Let's try a different area then. Alright, we are back in the main hall with our buddy Anubis. You are my friend. Yeah. Okay, the third area is demonology. And in the back we have three plaques, obviously for three keys hidden in each of the three areas. It suddenly hits me that I should probably start by going to neither area and going to the staff room. I have a flashlight. Your darkness does not impose me. Aha, chair. Be gone with you. Okay. The 13th of December, 1908. Dear Professor Walker, following last week's health and safety inspection, I am writing to inform you of the egregious health and safety oversights I have witnessed within your museum. All of the issues must be addressed before I can even consider giving you the green light to open to the public. Firstly, the elevators to the Atlantis exhibit and the planetarium must have railings, at least 3 feet tall, to prevent visitors from falling over the elevator while it's in motion. That's actually a good idea. The same restriction applies to the openings left when the elevator is not present. Secondly, while I appreciate your dedication to authenticity, I cannot allow open flames in a public place. As such, all torches, bonfires, and the like must be removed or replaced. Thirdly, I ask your engineer about the safety measures implied in the various door opening mechanisms throughout the museum, and was shocked to hear there are none. These mechanisms absolutely must... These These mechanisms absolutely have to be able to stop if blocked by a person or object. The same can be said for your elevators. Finally, all mazes should have clearly defined exit, or staff on hand to guide people through should they get lost. I must have gotten stuck in one of your mazes for the better part of 10 minutes. Even more troubling, though, is that I've heard rumors of one of your early guests' children becoming lost in the maze for hours, and were actually locked in the museum overnight. I hope you can appreciate that there's just no way I can allow the museum to open in this state. Please contact me again once these issues are fixed and we can arrange a second inspection. I look forward to having your museum a pass next time. To giving your museum a pass next time. Yours sincerely, Anne Marshall. And then she was killed. Horribly. Ooh. I saw something there. Can't move that. I am no longer able to defy physics with the boxes still. That still saddens me. And that tells me nothing except that there are bad things coming in the future. My chairs are still there. Good. Are you still moving too? Who's out there? Alright, so Egypt or demonology? Well, our good buddy Ramses here. Ramses? No, Anubis. Why am I... I'm dumb. Like, I knew it was wrong right away. Oh, I'm gonna be wrong about that, too. Somehow, I completely forgot that the guy with the... Whoa. That the doghead guy was an Anubis. The jackal. It was someone else entirely, and I'm an idiot. Scarabs. Mortar and pestle. I think that's what it's called. Oh, there's something back there. Clearly, I must move this block. Unclearly is how. That word means that there's something in here to worry about, doesn't it? Professor Walker's diary. It's finally in my hands, Bella wrote last week to inform me that she had acquired the crystal fragment I was after. Of course, knowing how much I wanted it, she saw fit to double her fee, certain that I'd pay any amount to get my hands on the artifact. The shard is unlike anything I have ever seen. It looks to have been cleanly cut from a much larger structure, but the material looks much too hard. Surely such a precise incision would be impossible. It's beautiful, truly magnificent. Its dull glow is soothing, hypnotic even. Now I can proudly put it on display in time for my pre-opening party next week. Good for you. We got blocks here. Where is this crystal? Okay, it's a sphinx. Well, oh, sphinx there. That looks like something I can mess with. There's only two rooms in here? And why don't you need to worry about sound? I have yet to find something. Oh! Interesting. Okay, first up, let's go up here. Let's go up here. Damn it, stop fighting me. Oh, it's a translation guide. I need that. I need that. I can't zoom in. Got this box though. There we go. Alright. Look at all these things I'm not gonna remember. Alright, let's just remember clearly a few key ones and we'll tie it later. So, feather is I, the weird spiral thing is H, and this paperclip looking or pair of tongs thing is O. I'm basically thinking, if I see this, they're probably talking about, like, I'm assuming that I'm gonna have to identify something later, and I'm assuming it's gonna be an Egyptian god, so I for Isis, H for Horus, and O for Osiris. Oh, it's probably a timer thing. Go. It's open! Good! You're gonna seal me in, aren't you? You! Yeah, I can see why this failed all the inspection tests. Torches, though. They are a nice touch. They make me want to search these pointers, though, because I do not want to be spooked by something that's standing in there. Hey, it's Anubis again! Got another door over here. Let's see what's up here first. A book. The tombs of many pharaohs were protected against grave robbers. The resting place of King Teos was hidden behind a secret door in his tomb. It is said to have been guarded by curses and other supernatural forces. The name of the pharaoh himself was used to seal the tomb. Shit. I did not think of that. Alright, maybe looking at it closely automatically put it in like my memory or something. Do I have an inventory? This thing doesn't have a quick save system. I only see a menu pop up when I go up and it's like an auto saves. Oh, okay. This is the chart there. O was a feather. So feather goes here. I know that. Wait, no. That was it. I was a feather. And the tongs were the frickin'. The tongs were O. E. There's gotta be a guide somewhere. Why would you put it in the other room but not in this room? This is where you need it. Especially when you've sealed the gate and I cannot leave. That is a dick move. A royal dick move. That means I gotta go through guessing games. But thankfully, I know one of them, so I can get it out of here. By removing one, we have cut off more than double of the possibilities. So. Wait. Oh, that one! That one is, that one was. Shit. Oh, H, that's H, so that cannot possibly be it. Good. And it can't possibly be. There's no eliminations on the bottom. Okay. My memory is crap. I should have written them down better. Doesn't matter. We're gonna do it. I'm gonna look in the other room, see if there's another chart in here, maybe. There is none. Damn it. I should have memorized the chart better. At least I have the O. Okay, so I know one thing on the top that is not it. So we're gonna use you here, and we're gonna do a process of elimination. Okay, that's what's gonna happen right now. There's three possibilities on the top, four here and four here. That gives us a total of 16 times 3. 48. 48 possible combinations. Okay. Oh, that was fast. Huh. I was expecting to have to fast forward that. Key. Awesome. All right. Does that mean you open the rock up here now? It looks open. Why did I have to worry about sound from running? That didn't make any sense to me. I don't see any penalty to running. Alright, we have one of the keys. Do you believe in me now, Anubis? Gonna go stick that key in here. We are Don't know which one goes where. I guess it doesn't matter. Alright! We did it! So, the downside is, now leads me to believe that there is something in there I have to do, and I don't know what it is. So next time, instead, I'm gonna go into demonology! Yep! I know nothing about what they got in there. So, let's take a peek first. It's dark. Okay. That's ominous. But we're not going up there until the next one. So, thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you next time. Later.